Hi Taurus, welcome back to my channel. Welcome to your Do They Miss You Love Tarot reading. I will be doing these in August. This will be a general reading to have a look and see if someone you've been thinking about, someone that you're no longer connected to, if this person does miss you. Now, you might have not been talking for a week, a month, a year. If you are meditating on this person, if you're thinking about them, the cards could reveal if they do in fact miss you and how they're feeling about your situation. So I do advise you approach these messages with an open mind and an open heart. Thanks so much for being here. Let's jump straight into it and see. Does this person miss you, Taurus? Do they miss you? Okay, these cards wanted to come out. The Death card with the Queen of Swords and the Star card. Okay, this is quite interesting. Now, the Death card is here. So this is about major endings, major transformations. I actually feel like there's someone still hung up about the way you ended things with them or the way you disconnected. The Death card is really a parting of ways. It's massive change. So I feel like for this person, the way you ended or the way you disconnected or the way they disconnected, however the circumstances played out, I feel like with the Death card, this was a major change for them. And I feel like with the Queen of Swords and the Star card also here, this person is missing you, but they're really, really wanting to heal. So A, I think they're still healing. They're still coming to terms with the ending, in fact, with the Death card here. The Death card is also Scorpio energy, so this may be more heightened if you have a Scorpio person here. Or B, this could point to mysteries and elusiveness. So if you haven't heard from this person, if it's been literally just disconnection and you haven't heard anything, you haven't been in touch, I do feel like this person is actually suppressing feelings. Not that Scorpios suppress feelings, but they're very good, because they're quite emotional beings, they're very good at keeping things a mystery. So I feel like the way this person is presenting themselves is that it's still a mystery and they're not alluding you too much. So they're not being obvious in their feelings. So I'm seeing there's suppression of feelings happening around this person, okay? With death comes life. I feel like they're trying to have a new perspective of things. The Queen of Swords is here, actually. Now, she's very direct. She's very, very intellectual. She's very in touch with her analytical mind. The fact that it looks like she's holding, I mean, not really, I mean, to me it does, but obviously people will see it differently. What she holds up here, it almost looks like a crossbow, like an archer's crossbow, and that she's almost ready to shoot, she's almost ready to aim. Because she wants to complete something. See how it's half completed? She almost wants to complete it here. And it's almost like she's shooting straight for the Star card. Now, if you have dealt with an air sign, a Gemini, Aquarius in particular, or a Libra, this person is wanting to heal and wanting to move on, okay? They've got their eyes set on the Star card here. Now, the Star card is also hope and magic, so there might be someone who's hoping to reconnect with you and might do that through ways of communication, email, social media, etc. There could be a correlation here for some of you. I feel like with the Queen of Swords, this person has been talking about you a lot. There's been a lot of communication, or they've been either speaking to a friend, an ex, or someone new that they're seeing. They're still mentioning you. So A, you're still coming up in their thoughts, Taurus. B, I feel like they're telling other people about you because they want to heal from you, because there is an ending. There is an ending here, but I feel like they're still coming to terms with that ending. I'm not sure if there's missing yet, because I feel like the circumstances around the way in which the two of you disconnected, this person is still registering. I do feel like a part of them does want to move on, and they're hopeful that they can move on. But the fact that they're hoping and wishing for a lot with the Star card here speaks volumes of, you know, the subconscious. And that's the subconscious here with the Death card. That's the suppression. That's the mysticism. Things that are under the radar. So the fact that that's come up, Taurus, I feel like it says that subconsciously this person still misses you. Or they're still dealing with emotions. Yes, they're talking to people about it. They're seeking advice or seeking solace and comfort in other things or people. And yes, that is a source of comfort for them. You know, with the Star card, I really feel like the Star card can indicate renewal, which is further supported by the Death card. The Star card is Aquarian energy. Aquarian energy can be all about the self, self-awareness, self-intelligence, self-growth. They're high achievers. They're people that always strive for the best. This is them as a sign. They're people that want to move on and want to appear a certain way. So I do feel like there is someone who is trying to move on from you. There's a missing, and I wouldn't be surprised if they still check into your social media page or have or will have contact through the media or internet, or you know, where other people can see these sort of platforms. Maybe there could be something here, in particular if it is an Aquarius. But the Star card also speaks of destiny, so I do feel like this person feels you're destined to have come into their life, or you taught them something. I do feel like regardless of how things ended, this person places a special importance on you, on your connection, whether it was brief, whether it was long, whether there was commitment, whether there was exclusivity or monogamy or not. A part of this person, whether they understand it now or it's still in their subconscious, that will transit into the known, the understanding, that you have come into their life for a purpose or for a reason, or you've taught them something, you've educated, you've mentored, you've taught, you've raised their self-awareness, you've helped them grow as a person. This is coming up around them, so this is quite interesting. But I definitely feel they have a certain element of respect for you here. I do. Whether they show that or not might still be in the subconscious here for a lot of them. But I do feel like there could be someone who's wanting to heal. So that might be someone that wants friendship or something platonic with you, okay? And they might also want renewal. They could even want fresh starts with you as well, Taurus. So you might hear from this person, okay? I will leave it at that, though. Hope this reading has been insightful. Thanks for tuning in.